It's 106 miles to Chicago. We got a full tank of gas, half a pack of cigarettes. It's dark, and we're wearing sunglasses. Hit it.
Everybody out there in Spreaker land, here we are. It's the Robbo and I, Johnny Spurling, Robbo, Russell the Robbo Robinson, or shall I say, Rabinovich, before 1954.
Something like that, yeah.
Pre-1954, Rabinovich by. Russell Rabinowitz.
That's me.
That's a Yid's name, boy.
I'm not from this parish. I'm from downtown Warsaw, mate.
What you can hear in the background is it's a terrible game of basketball, is it?
But England look like they're going to beat France.
Oh, do they?
England women, though. Is going to beat France?
England women. That's not really important, is it? It's women. So how many gold medals now then, Russ?
I don't know. I only watched one thing today.
What did you watch?
I watched the tennis.
Yeah, I watched the tennis. Very good.
Oh, so you're rooting for him now, are you? Because he's Olympics.
Did you watch that Scottish cunt?
Oh, but you're cheering other Scottish cunt.
Who, Federer?
No, somebody else who's Scottish in the Olympics, and they get a medal. So you won't?
No.
So Chris Hoy, you didn't cheer when he got a medal?
Didn't really care about Chris Hoy.
Didn't care. So what about if a Scots person wins, you won't cheer? You won't say well done?
They don't cheer us on, boy.
What?
They hate us.
We're supposed to all be together.
It's bollocks, isn't it? Well, did you see us? Did you see it?
You shouldn't be doing any. You shouldn't be cheering England of Great Britain on at all. You don't believe in Great Britain.
I don't believe in Great Britain at all.
So then you shouldn't be. You shouldn't care about.
Well, I don't.
You shouldn't say how many medals have we got.
Well, you know.
No, I don't, because you're talking shit. You're either going to support him or you're not, because of what he said 10 years ago or whatever. You're not going to support him. He was fantastic today. I've got to tell you, Murray was fantastic.
Yeah.
Fan-fucking-tastic. One of the best tennis I've ever seen.
I
don't like tennis. And he was playing the best player, well, the second best player in the world. And he was fucking good, mate, I'll tell you.
He's still going to beat Federer, though.
Well, I hope he does. I hope he does beat Federer. I really do hope he does. I don't think he will, but I really do. If it's over three sets, I reckon he'd beat him.
Well, it was over three sets last time, wasn't it?
No, it was five. Semi, all the way up to the final in the Olympics is three sets.
Oh, yeah.
And then the final is five sets. If it was three sets, I reckon he might beat him. But I would love him to beat him. I would absolutely love it. I would love it if he beat him. Love it. I would. Because I like the man. I don't know why, but I like him.
Yeah, I know you do.
Yeah, is it just me or have you noticed how much these Chinese swimmers have come on since Morecambe Bay? That's a bit sick, Gav.
Oh,
that's a good one, though.
Another message. These are the pros and cons of... Right, anyway, I'll just tell you a little bit about that song. That was The Pros and Cons of Hitchhiking by Roger Waters, 1984. I think it's actually his... It was in the middle of that album, Russ. In the middle of that album, if you remember rightly, it reverts back to the wall. Remember? A bit of music.
There's bits of the wall in it.
Bits of the wall in it. So it's, he wrote it directly after the wall, didn't he?
Yeah. He wrote it as a
Floyd album.
Floyd album. He's got Eric Clapton on guitar.
You see.
David Sanborn on
sax.
Jack Palance playing the hitchhiker.
Yeah.
The motorbike.
What is the story? What is the story behind it?
What?
Pros and cons of hitchhiking.
Not really, no.
I think he kills the two people who are in the back of the car at the beginning. So there's two hitchhikers he picks up, doesn't he?
Yeah.
He has a glance and he has a look and he pulls over. And I think he kills them.
Nice.
I think that's what it's about.
Nice entertainment.
I think that's what it's about. What is it?
A woman sued a hospital stating that after recent treatment, her husband has lost interest in sex. The doctor replied, "All we did was correct his eyesight." I'm not reading these jokes pretty good, but because I've got to scroll down, so I can't.
Why can't I?
Oh, you sent that twice, did you? I know. I'll tell you a joke. I can't tell jokes, but I'll tell you a joke. This old Jewish geezer in the Sinai Desert.
Yeah.
Walking in the Sinai Desert, and he kicks a lamp. He sees like an old lamp, and he kicks it, and the genie comes out.
Oh, yeah.
And the genie says to you, "Right, I can give you two wishes.
Yeah.
And he thinks about it, he goes, right, well, the first thing I want to do is, you know, I'd like for peace in the Middle East. I'd like peace between Israel and its neighbours.
Sure.
And the genie says, can't do that. You can't do that. And he says, well, why can't you do it? He says, can't. He looks at the map. He looks at the map he draw. He's drawn him a map, the fella, of what he wants. And he says, he looks at it, I can't do it. It's too much. There's too much, you know, there's too much politics around it. They'll never agree to it. I can't get people. I can't do that. It's one of the only wishes that I cannot grant. And he said, well, what's your second wish? He went, well, I wish that you could let my wife give me oral sex. And the genie picks up the map and goes, just let me have a look at that map again. Get it? Get it? Because he's Jewish.
Yeah, Jewish. Of course. I get it.
Saw that on Old Jews Tell Jokes.
Oh, what is it? Old Jews, of course, yeah. They're very good, are they?
Yeah, they chat it much better than me.
They're very clever.
Can't tell jokes, sorry about that, folks. I tell stories about the war.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah.
I like your stories about the war.
I don't know.
Well, basically, it's all about, it's about your knob and the war, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, how much spunk you delivered in General Eisenhower's eye.
No, not that one.
None?
No, it's Himmler, wasn't it?
Himmler's eye.
Himmler's eye.
He spoke in Himmler's eye.
The other day, it was King Harold.
From the
Battle of Hastings,
1066. That's where I got that, all that wrong mixed up, didn't I? Well, of course I did.
Got mixed up with what?
Well, I got 1066 mixed up with 1866 or something. Because 1866 was the Great Fire of London, right?
No. That was 1606.
No.
1666.
1666. No, I meant 1666. Yeah, that was the Great Fire of London, wasn't it?
You know they put out the Great Fire of London, didn't you?
Yeah.
Got me in, didn't they?
What were you know?
Got me a piss on it. They said, they come and they, oh, Verity, we are in a deep, deep doo-doo, they said. Because they spoke like that in them days. We have of this fireth in Londoneth that we cannot put outeth. It started in Pudding Laneth, and it's moving all across the city, and it's burning everything in its wake. We don't give a fuck about the poor people, but it's taking in the fucking rich. It's taking in their houses now. Samuel Pepys is going pot house. He's writing a fucking book about it. Can you put it out? And I said, well, I'll have a go. I'll have a bash. So I've got the old todger out. Tremendous force of a piss.
Ugh.
Just sprayed the area. 2 days later, it was out, mate.
Yeah.
It was out.
You've done well there, didn't you?
If you read Pepys's diary, it says, and lo, Russell Robinson came and pissed over the... Pisseth over the fireth.
It was before 1950, you've Rabinowitch.
Yeah, Russell Rabinowitch, he said.
That's it.
He said, some dirty Pole. Some dirty Hebrew, he said. That's what he said.
Ah, that's not that.
Well, you know, they were uneducated in them days, didn't they?
They always are.
Peeps didn't like the old Jews.
Well, hello, Peeps, me old mate.
Hello, Peeps.
That has to go back a few years, isn't it? Yeah. Hello, Peeps. Is that 84, 85? No, 87.
About that, yeah.
That's where he started, wasn't it? His best character was, I think, Loads of Money.
Loads of Money.
That's a very funny character. You didn't realise that it was called Paul Whitehouse.
Yeah.
Clever man.
Paul Whitehouse was right, wasn't he?
Yeah. With
Charlie Hickson.
Anyway, let's have a record, shall we? That's your record, lad?
Yeah, record me off.
Yeah, we'll have a record, lad. Oi, used to play us another couple of tunes, you cunts.